Hey guys, what's up? So in this course, we'll continue our discussion on geography approach, and this will be talking about detailed syllabus of both prelims as well as mains, plus the previous year questions so that you can correlate what type of questions are asked. This is presented by me, Roman Seni, and you can leave your reviews and ratings in the comments, and you can ask your doubts, queries in the comments below, and you can follow me on an academy on this link. So what is an approach of a typical aspirant? So he first reads the syllabus, then he reads the previous year question paper. Like ideally he or she should be doing this. Then she should shortlist the books which she wants to study. Then she should develop a study approach. Then coaching or personal notes depending on her preference. And then revision strategy. And then finally practice and repeat the same thing again and again. Unfortunately, people directly jump to coaching and personal notes without going through these four steps, which is a very bad thing. So for example, syllabus for prelims, it includes like Indian and the world geography, for example, physical geography, social geography, economic geography, general issues like environmental ecology, biodiversity and climate change. That's what it all says, that's all. There is nothing more than this in the prelim syllabus. So obviously, it is not an adequate guide. But what is an adequate guide is the previous year question papers as well as mains syllabus. So see syllabus for mains, it says that general studies paper 1 will include salient features of world's physical geography. Okay, world's physical geography is definitely coming. Distribution of key natural resources across the world with special emphasis on South Asia and the Indian subcontinent. So they want you to read about South Asia and Indian subcontinent more and world about and also about the world. And factors location for primary, secondary and tertiary industries in various parts of the world including India. Again, this becomes an important topic. Then important geophysical phenomena such as earthquake, tsunami, volcanic activity, cyclone, etc. They are also to be dealt with. Then geographical features and their location. Example, changes in critical geographical features including water bodies, ice caps, etc. and flora and fauna and effects of such changes. So they are all important part of your main syllabus. So you need to go through them in detail. Just read it like 10 times a day so that you know exactly if such kind of news appears. Can you see they have specifically mentioned like ice caps, melting, water bodies rising, changes in flora and fauna. All these are like directly related to climate change. So they have specifically mentioned it. Then syllabus for mains part 2 includes general studies paper 3, like major cropping patterns in various parts of the country, different types of irrigation, irrigation system storage, transport and marketing of agricultural produce, issues and related constraints, e-technology in the aid of farmers. All these are like directly or indirectly related to geography and agriculture. Then land reforms in India, again it can be taken into history or geography, like depending on the subject. Conservation, environmental pollution, degradation, environmental impact assessment, disaster and disaster management. All these require certain knowledge of geography to be understood. Now let's take example of past year papers and see how it was related to current affairs, so that you have a better understanding of what kind of questions are asked, so that you can focus on certain topics and analyze how UPSC approach a particular topic. For example, question 1, it includes which of the following are the tributaries of Brahmaputra, Dibang, Kamang or Lohit. So answer is like all of them are, so let's say Lohit is a like tributary definitely because Lohit is a district in Arunachal Pradesh, Brahmaputra flows through that. So these are the kind of questions. There might be more tributaries, less tributaries. So you need to know the answers. The answer here is not important. I'm just focused on the type of questions which are asked. Then with reference to initiative for nutritional security through intensive millet promotion, which of the following statements are correct? So now it is related to agricultural scheme. So you need to know about millets production, what are millets, everything like that. So obviously it is not true that they are shifting commercial crops to millet production. That is not true. So you have to know certain things. You need to go through the question papers. We will be solving them separately. Then the area known as Golan Heights sometimes appear in the news in the context of events related to. Answer is Middle East in this case. So answer is B. Very, very simple. Golan Heights is like acquired by Israel. It belonged to Syria earlier. Now there is a dispute of the territory between these two countries. So you need to know where Israel or Syria are. Obviously they are in Middle East. So if you know your newspaper, if you have read the Hindu properly, you will not get it wrong. 100% guaranteed if you have just read the Hindu. Then in which of the following regions of India are shale gas resources found? Again, if you have read Hindu, then you will not do it wrong. Kaveri Basin, Krishna Godavari Basin, Kambe Basin, all these appear in news frequently. So answer is D in this case. But just reading the Hindu newspaper would have sufficed. Now, if you travel through the Himalayas, you are likely to see which of the following plants naturally growing there. So if you have just gone through your prelims, NCRTs properly, then you will get it right. So answer becomes Like obviously you'll not find sandalwood in Himalayas, but oak and rhododendron are present. So maybe the answer here is not important. Again and again I'm saying, maybe like I'm wrong with some answers, but you just have to like focus on the questions focus. Now, which of the following has been accorded geographical indication status? Now, so it becomes important that not only these three, but you know all the GI indicators, specifically those which are coming in the news frequently. So all three are obviously, they have been accorded GI, but now it becomes important who gives this GI status, what is the definition of geographical indication. So all these becomes important, like does it has a legal sanctity, what if it is violated, does it give some commercial benefits to the local people. Now mains question, let's see. Mumbai, Delhi and Kolkata are three mega cities of the country, but the air pollution is much more serious problem in Delhi as compared to the other two. Why is this so? So obviously you cannot refute the argument because examiner himself is saying that the problem is very serious in Delhi. So you need to know the reasons, why their reason, is there certain industries, is this climate is such, why is the problem so worse in Delhi? So you need to analyze it properly and need to give like 4 or 5 supporting arguments in favor of why pollution is more in Delhi or why it is not so in Mumbai or Kolkata. Maybe because sea is very close to Bombay, Kolkata, some role is played by that, or whatever might be the reason, you don't know, but you need to study that in detail. Then how far do you agree that the behavior of Indian monsoon has been changing due to humanizing landscapes? Then you need to like analyze the data. Yojana magazine always come with a monsoon special. Hindu talks about the monsoon a lot. So if you know these kind of things, if you have made proper notes, then you will not do this wrong. You can discuss it properly. Then why are the world's fold mountain systems located along the margins of the continent? This is a very, very specific like geographical question, which any good student of geography is known to, like he can write a good answer. Now bring out the association within the global distribution of fold mountains and earthquakes and volcanoes. So you will find there is a very strong association between them. So anyway, just to give you an idea, the like directly questions are asked. Tropical cyclones are largely confined to South China Sea, Bay of Bengal and Gulf of Mexico. Why? First of all, they are tropical in nature, so they are obviously will be present in tropical regions. So they are all three are tropical regions. That is one argument. But why does not it happen at the other tropical regions of the world? That is a certain argument. So you need to support it in that light. Then it is said that India has substantial reserve of shale oil and gas, which can feed the needs of the country for quarter century. However, tapping of the resources doesn't appear to be high on the agenda. Like, so I answered this properly during my mains time. So like it was very relevant then, not so relevant now. It might become important later when India actually like it becomes one of the major sources of energy. And like finally bring out the causes for more frequent landslides in the Himalayan and Western Ghats. Again, there were a lot of landslides going on at that time. So we had to answer this properly in our mains. So it's very basically like obviously there are certain factors related to that. So if you read geography of that state properly, you'll be able to answer it. So thank you for watching this lesson. Have an awesome day.